So when cats have diabetes, the main issue that happens is their blood sugar becomes significantly elevated, and that's what causes the clinical signs that most owners observe at home. The most common clinical signs that we see associated with diabetes are going to be excessive appetite, we call that polyphagia, excessive water consumption, we call that polydipsia, excessive urination, which is called polyuria, and then often weight loss. Those are going to be the four most common signs that we see associated with diabetes. There are a lot of disorders that can cause similar clinical signs. The way that we help distinguish those different disorders is usually obviously doing a good thorough physical exam, and then often starting by what we call a minimum database of information, which typically includes some lab work, including blood testing and urine testing. So sometimes additional testing is required to get that definitive diagnosis of diabetes. Specifically in the cat, a lot of cats can develop a stress effect where their blood sugar can be significantly elevated, even in the presence where they don't actually have diabetes. So running a specific blood test called a serum fructosamine can really help us to establish that diagnosis. There are some cats that develop kind of what we call type 2 diabetes, meaning they may or may not require insulin the rest of their lives. Some of these cats can be managed successfully with a diet change and also getting them to lose weight. Some of the cats that we do see that are diagnosed with diabetes are obese at the time of diagnosis, and getting them on the proper diet and getting weight loss involved, their diabetes may go into remission. Cats with diabetes are at an increased risk for developing urinary tract infection, and that's for a couple different reasons. Number one, the excessive amount of sugar there provides a good substrate for potentially for bacteria to grow, and also the urine of dogs and cats that have diabetes tends to be a little bit more dilute than that of a normal dog, and again, it impairs the body's ability to kind of fight off that infection. If you're noticing any changes in behavior that are unusual for your pet, I certainly recommend having them evaluated by a veterinarian, and again, specifically if you're noticing excessive water consumption, excessive urination volume, and certainly excessive appetite, those can be signs of an endocrine disorder or other abnormalities.